looks tight, but I can squeeze through.
Hold for identiscan.
One of these again.
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
Dr. Sobek, you are 355,510 days overdue for your meeting with Mr. Fairman. Please proceed to the 35th floor.
Wait. 350,000? That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
Protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, quantum encryption, black quartz stuff, way beyond military grade. That's what you demanded. So that's what we delivered.
You don't code something you can't crack. All we need is a backdoor. Upload the latest service pack update and the problem goes away.
You specifically forbade us from leaving anything resembling a backdoor in code. Every protocol to black quartz standard. Your words. Look. If you need me to fudge some projections, it's nothing we haven't done before.
I don't need fudged projections. I need a way to reassert control over the Heart's Timor Swarm.
I don't know what to tell you, Ted. You're asking the impossible.
So, codes. They needed codes of some kind to control the machines. But they got out of control. Sounds bad. Statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill. And they honored it?
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today. With over 25,000 human employees based in nations and corporate holdings across the globe, Feral leads the world in every sector of self-sustaining, fully automated technology. From revolutionary consumer products close to home, like the Feral Focus, to the dynamic chariot line of peacekeeping robots halting bloodshed in conflict zones across the globe, Feral remains committed to making the...
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your Focus. They'll help you understand.
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Feral Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is... Trust me. We will be exploiting a massive, growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, but then they stopped to make other kinds of weapons? Why? Can't carry more. Another cave-in. But I could get through. But I can use that as a ramp to get back up. Looks like I can climb here. People were angry at Faro, at the corporation. They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
CA3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance. The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction. The BOR-7 Horus. Imagine your complete engagement ecosystem comprehensively managed by a high-speed learning machine network. Whether your need is to replace battlefield losses or intensify force projection, the Horus's onboard manufacturing capabilities mean you'll never get stuck waiting for the next arms delivery. Simply redefine your force parameters, and the Horus will fabricate additional units to
Looks like the way up. What's left of it? Gonna be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobek. Plants can find a way to hang on up here. Guess I can too.
That began when they engaged in unauthorized offensive operations.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace. Got too much already. Heavy. World's going white. No room. A way up. All it takes is a few good handholds. All right. Made it. Wonder what we'll find.
Do you wish to deploy Alpha privileges to recover purged data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
A file has been recovered.
Elizabeth, good to, It's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch. In the chariot line.
Your killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data, then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobek here, but they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I...
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it and let... Whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final Faro has been recovered.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I am speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What?
Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
What made her solution so terrible? What did she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
Good. Another power cell. If I find more, I should be able to get to that ancient armor I found.
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the Old Ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that Pharaoh robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Silence, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
All right, Silence. You've made your point. I came to these ruins hoping to learn more about this Elizabeth Sobek. And I have, but I still don't understand my connection to her. Or why the Eclipse is trying to kill me. Or who Hades is. No answers, just one question after another.
Exactly. Which is why it's time to expand your frame of inquiry. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobek.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that Pharaoh robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Not so fast, Silence. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobeck could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly. An ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation. Wasting time. Now, if that's enough talking, be on your way.
Oh no. I'm just getting started. You've been getting a free ride on my focus, risking nothing while I risk everything. All I have to do is take this thing off my head, and you'll be blind, deaf, and dumb. So quit complaining and answer my questions.
Very well. Proceed.
You've been using my focus to spy on me. How's that possible?
Every focus emits a signal, a voice, that only other focuses can hear. I know how to string those voices together, how to make them talk to each other, to communicate, even over vast distances.
How do you learn to do that?
Years of study and experimentation. In principle, it's not so different from how you override machines. I override focuses.
And you can spy through other Eclipse's focuses, too.
Usually. All I'll say is that overriding the connections is complicated.
Who are you, Silence? And what are your intentions?
You really need to make this personal? I'm a lone wanderer who left his tribe behind a long time ago. An explorer of forbidden places, a searcher of lost knowledge. Exactly as I said.
Why do you know so much about the Eclipse?
I happen to know a lot about a lot of things. If what you're really asking is whether I work for the Eclipse or anyone else, I don't. I am nothing if not independent.
You said you've known for some time that Pharaoh war machines destroyed the civilization of the Old Ones.
The evidence pointed that way. But until now, I never knew the full scope of their danger. That they could process organic matter into fuel, or that the Horus class could manufacture more robots. Like a cauldron on legs.
But the robots we've seen so far, the Corruptors and Deathbringers, they don't do those things.
Not yet, anyway. So far, we haven't encountered any that are undamaged. At full power, who knows what they're capable of.
So far as I can tell, the Eclipse are just following orders. It's Hades who wants me dead. Who is he?
I don't know. The Eclipse describe him as a buried shadow, some kind of devil.
That thing that spoke to me outside, that made that focus explode. That was Hades. It didn't seem like a person or a machine. More like a phantom. With a terrible voice.
All that's certain is that he wants you dead.
Because of my connection to Elizabeth, Has to be.
Hades is using the Eclipse to resurrect Pharaoh robots.
But if Elizabeth found a way to stop them centuries ago, if she made special weapons, maybe Hades is worried I'll do the same thing.
In some of the ancient data I've recovered, there are hints of so-called super weapons being developed. Maybe to stop the robots, the civilization of the old ones had to destroy itself.
Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asaram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved. Well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least. U.S. Robot Command next, to learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.